Mile, Ada from Witch Bike here. Right, this is the second part, or second video in my MV Agusta Brutale Dragster RR800 Pirelli Limited Edition, what a mouthful, video series. So you'll be experiencing my journey with me, that I picked the bike up. I'm going to talk about now my first impressions riding it. I'm going to look at a video of me riding it, what my honest thoughts are. I'm going to move on to the parts I'm putting on it and showing what I do and what I add on and how they look. And also we're going to do a proper exhaust comparison, get an exhaust coming. That'll be interesting to see what the difference is between that beautiful standard 3-exit exhaust on the side of the bike and a single can edition, which lightens it up, adds more flavour and ferocity, but also tidies up that bottom part of the bike that I wasn't 100% happy with. A great thanks to Powerslide Motorcycles near Stoke for their great work and support in delivering this bike to me. And well, I was given some extra bits. It is really exciting. It's all a bit silly, but look what you get when you buy an MV Agusta. It's all about the details. When you put a bike next to any other bike, whether it's a Ducati V4S, a Street Fighter, a Tuono, whatever you want, as much as you want, the details in MV Agustas kick ass. And one of the details you get is this limited edition plaque. How bloody marvellous is that? Dragster R800 Pirelli MV Agusta Motor SPA certifies that you are the proud owner of the Dragster 800 RR Pirelli Limited Edition number 122 of 200. Woohoo! Isn't that good? Of course, what I did, I came over, put it on the mantelpiece in the lounge. And as you may know from other videos, the missus hates me motorcycling. I can't even mention it. And she wasn't happy. So I was out. She took that down. And this picture of me at Brands Hatch, my first ever track day. I'll put the link to that in the detailed description below. So yeah, she wasn't happy, but a bit of a laugh didn't last long. But there you go. So that's nice. The other thing is this beautiful box. I mean, it's a beauty, absolute beauty. Look at it, really solid. Now let's open it up and I'll show you what's in it. So you open it up, you've got a welcome letter. Obviously that's pre-printed, but still very nice. Welcome you to the MV Agusta family. On the back is the signatures, not real, printed, of all the people that worked on the bikes. Of course, there is a signature, I believe, on my bike somewhere of the man who was responsible, or signed it off, or hand-built it, because they're all hand-built, remember? And then you get a lovely little wallet thing, which included all his bits of documentation. There's telling you about how this box was handmade by a craftsman. See the details. Some MV stickers, which I'll be definitely using. A beautiful warranty booklet, just the way it's kind of done. And then inside, looky, 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 you get a rather attractive, as he says, more struggles to get it out, big old user's manual. Now I've already looked at that a few times. And then a couple of little nice accoutrements. Look at this, look. First off, you've got this MV Agusta metal motorcycle art, ride safe. And in there is a USB key. How fantastic is that? 4 gigabytes. And they're beautifully presented. I mean, just awesome, isn't it? So that's handy. So I'll put that, oh, I would put it on the key, but I wouldn't want to scratch the bike. And then you get this as well. You can clip it onto your leathers, wallet, jeans, whatever. And you open it up. Easier said than done. Now there, you put your cards in there, etc. Business cards, debit cards, credit cards. And it's RCID proof, which means no one can nick your 30 or 40 quid or dollars as you go past a sensor. And that's pretty smart, and I'll be using that. So yeah, very nice. So far, so great. But let me take you to the bike now, and let's start my first impression video. Okay, so this is my first impressions of review of my fabulous looking Envy Agusta Brutale Dragster RR Pirelli Limited Edition. That's it in a nutshell. It's a rather large nutshell. Now parking up, it's had amazing views and have been the crowds around it and people asking about it. It's that kind of bike that just pops out and they're very, very rare. And of course in this particular livery you'll never see it again probably. So that gives you a big ego boost. It's a fantastic looking bike, but is it as good as it looks? So first impressions really, when I got on it, I thought actually the seat's quite tall. Now I'm not comfortably on the balls of my feet. I'm somewhere between the balls and tiptoes. I'm 5'10", I've got a 30 inch inside leg. So it's not particularly great from a seat height point of view for me. Shorter riders will need to take a little extra care when they come to a stop. The next thing I noticed was that the clutches are somewhere between stiff and medium, so it's, you know, rather it was lighter like a Chiono, but actually it's fine to deal with. And once you're in a second gear, you don't need it anyway, because the quick shifter is an absolute joy. Now it's one of the best quick shifters I've come across. It's not just that it's quick, it does what it says, but it also has a reassuring kind of clunk. Now some quick shifters, you don't ever, not really sure if it's just kind of gone in instantly. Especially when you're going down, because they're so smooth, they just kind of visibly seamlessly integrate into each other, which actually isn't good. This one's got a reassuring kind of clunk as it changes. It has a massive bang pop on the upshift. The other things, first impression wise, is that you are leaning forward on the bike. Now I find this bike tremendously uncomfortable. As you've been watching my channel for a while, you'll know that I have back and neck issues. And I can't, you know, I just utterly adore bikes, as you know, I've got such a passion. It is a bit of a struggle riding them for more about half an hour. Well, now it is a comfy bike. This bike is not comfortable by any means. So actually, let's get on to the negatives. First of all, the bike is very vibey. There's a lot of vibrations going on, probably worse than the BMW XR when it first came out. So when you're on a motorway, between about 60 and 80, it's not very nice at all. It's very unpleasant. So on top of the vibrations, it's an uncomfortable position as well, ergonomically really. You're somewhat leaned forward, there's a lot of pressure on your wrists, your shoulders and your hands, and my hands ache after a while. Plus the vibrations through the hands give me some sort of almost like pins and needles effect. That's only after a really long ride. American Liberties, the standard rear sets. The pedal for shifting is a little bit close, so you might want to consider getting adjustable rear set additional add-on. And the mirrors that came with the bike are actually very good, but I took them off because it's so wide. On the first ride back after buying my bike, I actually clipped the wing mirror of a car as I was filtering. So I thought, right, I'm having those off. So they've been taken off, and the front end of the bike now actually looks a lot more svelte. I can get a picture back on it. Now, if you can see that. I've also taken off the pillion pegs, but I need to get a blanking plate to do a proper job. And other negatives. God, it's so good looking, you're forever cleaning it and trying to make it look its absolute pristine best. Mainly as a favour to others, let them have a chance of falling in love with this beautiful bike. So you feel like there's a bit of pressure that you've got to maintain this bike to the utmost degree, because it's, you know, it's a privilege owning this bike, and I do have a lot of pride owning it, and it does stand out, it does get attention. Now that can be a negative, in that if you don't like attention, you don't want to get this bike. So generally, it's not ergonomically comfortable, it vibrates a lot. It's actually smoother than I thought it'd be, it's not as jerky. They've changed a lot, they've improved the mapping a hell of a lot on this bike. So that's not part of the problem. It's just generally uncomfortable bike. The seat is no good at man or beast. It's a tiny little bit of padding, probably a few millimetres, then a hard bit of plastic. So it looks incredible. I think it's the best rear end seat assembly bar none on any bike ever. So you do pay the price, that's sveltness. Gives you a sore ass. Now obviously I drove this bike 3.5 hours back from where I bought it, so I know about discomfort on this bike. Now when I take it out half an hour, 1 hour blast, as I have been doing, it's not so bad, you know.
But obviously that 3.5 hour ride completely killed me. I stopped a couple of times. My hands were buzzing to the point I could hardly feed them. Positives. Biggest positive was it looks. I've gone on that again and again because it is just a staggering bike. The details are unbelievable, which is where all the cost comes in, of course. But it feels very planted. In 2 days, I took it out to Donington. Went out and checked before it started raining. And my Donington video may not be up by the time you watch this. But on the track, it felt very smooth, very composed. It's got super Corsa tyres. Obviously Pirelli, because it's a Pirelli bike. And it worked really well. I was impressed with the steering. The inputs were exactly as I expect them to be. How they delivered those inputs to the bike was perfection. To be honest, I was really very impressed. Just a bit of beanage. This bike sounds pretty damn good. It goes up to about 12,000-13,000 revs. So you're kind of going fast to 8,000-9,000, but then it kind of either goes faster again. It's a mad bit of kit. Very enjoyable. It's actually quite flickable. It's a hell of a lot of fun, this bike. You know, it's that kind of fun that you'd have on a Super Naked, like a Chuono or a Super Duke car. Overall, I'm comfortableness wise, you cannot regret buying this. It's such a great bike and it's beautiful. I didn't realize it was going to be this uncomfortable. So if you're an older age person, this bike might not be for you. But for everybody else who wants something that stands out, that gets a lot of attention, is incredibly fun to ride, and it ticks all those other boxes, then this is great, bloody great. Now let's talk about the suspension. Now with my riding and my riding style, I haven't found a problem. It seems pretty good, but I am going to get a proper suspension setup where a professional takes it out, tinkers with it, does what it needs to do, and might change it drastically, might need to change it a little bit. I feel actually it's pretty good out of the box, which is pretty rare. And I've got pretty reasonable confidence going around bends if I hit a slight bump. Doesn't upset the bike in any way, shape or form. That would worry me. It comes off the line nicely, it brakes nicely. I think it's pretty much spot on out of the box, but with a professional's help, it might uncover even more. They sit quite far forward. Now, that's a real shame, because I'd rather sit further back and look at that beautiful, beautiful tank and front handlebar assembly. It's just beautiful. But alas, I hardly ever see it, and I come to stop. If I remember to look down, I kind of remind myself that I'm sitting on this beautiful piece of machinery, and I'm very lucky to own it. So in summary, it's uncomfortable, and it's got flaws. To make up for that though, by a long, long way, it's great fun. It looks incredible. I still maintain it's one of the best looking bikes I've ever seen in my life. And it's going to get a lot of attention, and you're going to feel marvellous riding it. So if you put up with the ergonomics, then it's a great bike to have. It's still very fast. I mean, I've got it in normal, and I still have not yet whacked it on full, because the front end goes light. I've not quite got that confidence level where I know I'm not going to freak myself out. So it's got plenty of power. Believe me, it's got the power of a 1 litre, because just the way they do the engine, it's just incredible. So, you know, don't not get this bike because you think one litre alternative's just going to do it for you. Believe me, this has got more than enough. More than enough to scare you, that is for sure. Some people talk about that the front damper, the standard one there, I mean, it has got one, is pretty shite. Now, I've had a couple of mini head shakes, but really, nothing like people have talked about. I've started to put on a bit of beanage. I haven't put on full maximum beanage on the sport mode. So it might come, Well, the dealer said that it doesn't really do much, just wasting your money, doesn't improve it much. And then other people on the forums are saying it improves it a lot, like night and day. So I think I'm just going to save up my 600 odd quid and get it, because it's just another bit of kit which should improve the bike. It's not going to damage the bike anyway, it's going to improve it slightly. And I might find it does a lot, because I don't want to have that first really severe front head shake and get myself in a bit of trouble. So I'd rather avoid it if I can, so it might just be a prevention technique. Right, now coming up, this is part of a series of videos that I'm doing on this very special bike. So it started off on my bike reveal video. This is the second one in the series, and I've got others coming up. I've going to be putting parts on the bike, talking about what I've taken off. I'm going to do a video comparison. I've got a new exhaust coming, and I'll go over the rationale why I've done that. And we'll look at the differences and how it feels. And then I'm going to take it on a track again. I'm a bit more confident, as long as it's dry. I'll take it on a track, have a bit of fun. We'll see how the bike copes on that. I mean, briefly in my short track excursion at Donington, the low-down mid-range grunt was more than enough to speed past superbikes. And by the time they'd kind of, the straights were massively long, but they wouldn't catch me up, because I'd hit a bend by the time they're about to overtake me, so they'd have to hold back. So really, this bike was actually supreme. I think only on a super long, straighted circuit would it really suffer in the hands of a similarly capable, as in novice, superbike rider. But it done the job for me, and it inspired me of confidence. So look out for the series. Make sure you like and subscribe and hit the bell to be informed of when my new stuff comes out.